Hey guys, yeah, it's UB40 again, because this is the second video today that I'm filming, so apologies if I'm hoarse, but now's the time to do it, I suppose, no time like the present. I just finished filming the Riot XO video, so now I'm going to move on to this. This is the Monterey Bay Knives Slayback, and this thing is really friggin' cool, guys. This is so cool. This is the double detent version of this knife. I know that now there's a flipper version that has a liner lock, essentially. They don't call it a liner lock, but it functions like a liner lock. Those are cool, but it's just not very unique. There's a lot of liner locks out there. That's why I wanted the double detent version. And this is also the carbon fiber version. I know that there's a titanium version. And there's multiple different versions of the carbon fiber. This one's called Raindrop. Now, it's going to be really hard to pick up the effect on camera. I'll try my best here. But this Raindrop carbon fiber is... this might be the nicest carbon fiber on any knife that I've ever seen. It feels really good. It's clearly very real. And it's kind of got this optical... behavior where, depending on the angle that you're holding it against the light, it changes, kind of. It's like those picture books, you know, when you're a kid, when you tilt a page, another part of the image shows, then you tilt it back and another part shows. I'm not sure what that's called, but this knife kind of has that. It's just, I can't really pick it up on the camera, but, you know, if you were to see this in person in the light, I really, really think you would be very impressed by it. On top of that, most of the Slaybacks are not black DLC blades. They're uncoated blades. Sorry about that. So rudely interrupted by the Amazon man delivering me the things that I ordered. Anyway, so as I understand it, this is actually kind of a special edition or a rare edition, not made in many numbers, not that any of them really are, but it took me a long time to find this, man, a real long time, and it is really, really worth it. So it says R. Laconico, Ray Laconico, he's the designer. I don't know very much about the company, about Monterey Bay Knives. I suppose they're in Monterey, Monterey, California, or near there. So I don't know if it's his company that he started or that he's a part of, or if he's just a designer that they buy designs from. I'm not really sure. Most of the MBK knives are not made in California or in the US. They're made in China. This one is also made in China. if that bothers you, well, it's made in China. As I think now that they do have an American-made model called the Sea Otter, I want to call it. It's either the Sea Otter or the Old Guard. One of those two is made in the U.S. I think it's their first American-made knife, but as far as, you know, things made in China go, people like to hate on China, and, you know, I kind of get it, because most low-price goods come from China. But, you know, then you've got things like the Spyderco Taichung Taiwan factory, which has legendary quality. And, you know, this knife is really, really good quality. So, no complaints there about China. This is a double detent knife. This is a slip joint knife. It's not a locking knife. And it's M390. So, how much cutting are you going to do with a slip joint? I guess a lot. Do you need M390 for a slip joint? You know, why not, guys? This is a high-end knife. you know, I wouldn't want 8CR, but, you know, I would have been happy with S20V, S30V, but M390, man. The new ones are actually ZDP 189, which is pretty interesting. It's a, at this point, I think everybody knows what ZDP 189 is, but if anything, it's at least an interesting steel. I'm not unhappy with M390, though. I have some other things in M390 that Spyderco has won. I don't have anything in ZDP, but M390 is great. So how does it feel to open and close? Well, it's stiff. Actually, I don't even really know if stiff is the word. Maybe it's just that the flipper doesn't provide a lot of leverage. But it is pretty tricky to open. Now, I can make it look pretty easy. But the first couple times I did it, I'm like, man, this is the stiffest, the heaviest detent. And when I hand this knife to people, they think the same thing. They really struggle to open the thing. Now, I have found the right angle and the right way to hold it and the right amount of pressure that I could just do it. And closing it is the same thing. So it's non-locking, it's a slip joint, but there's a detent to close it. You know, that's what's holding it open, essentially. So just like learning the opening detent, you have to learn the closing detent. So I think it's easiest to hold it kind of at the crest of the spine of the blade, right there, and just, I know how much pressure to do it to get it to close, but if you haven't practiced with this knife yet and you're not really sure the exact pressure, see, I can make it look easy now, but it took me a minute to learn that closing detent. If you press it too hard, this is what'll happen. Okay, so it'll close and slam back, and the detent won't catch it, and it'll bounce back out. So let me try to do that again. So I can make it happen, but at this point, I'm pretty good at the closing detent, so I can kind of snap it close. When cutting with it, you know, you could see here this jimping here. This is part of the actual blade, so when it, you know, if you hold it there, you could see how it goes back into the handle. If you put your index finger underneath there, that'll help it a little bit from closing on your finger, because kind of like on the Delica, you have this little lack of a finger choil. But if you let it close, you know, you can catch your finger on it, and the sharp part, you know, the blade will not hit your finger. So the Slayback has that going for it, at least. Really, I mean, there's not much to say about this knife that you guys can't see, you know, the dimensions and all that. It is just, this is now probably the fidgetiest knife I own. Before that, the reigning champion was Protech Malibu. This thing is still really fidgety. Look at that. But now, guys, I think we have a new champion. I think this is faster. Yep. This is now the fastest fidgeter knife that I own. And man, is it a beaut. So if you guys are thinking about getting a Slayback, you know, I think the EWCs look cool too. The kind of a spear point blade, but you know, this Slayback, you know, Swayback style, plus with the Warncliffe, oh man, this thing is just savage. Get yourself a Slayback if you can find one, guys.